I hope you people are enjoying the classes. Now, as I said, that question number 8 of the construction part exercise 14C will be dealt separately. Why? Because here we have to draw a parallel line, isn't it? We have to draw a parallel line through point P, through point P and parallel to AB, and parallel to AB means they have already given you a line. They have given you a line AB and they are asking you, not only they have given you line AB, they have also given you a point P somewhere over here, and they are asking you to draw a line which should be parallel to AB. So suppose this is my line which is parallel to AB. Okay, if this is AB, so naturally this line will be parallel to AB. Now the best part to prove that this particular line is parallel to this is to make alternate angles equal. I think the concept is clear up till now, that if a line is given, if a line AB is given and if a point P is given, okay, above AB, and we have to prove, we have to draw a line, another line which should pass through P and should be parallel to AB. Therefore, in that case, naturally we have to make the alternate angles equal. So you can see here, these are the alternate angles. You can also take this as the, this particular as the alternate angle, but I'll take the shorter angle. Now, how to make alternate angles equal is very important. Therefore, what I'll do, I am going to join this P to any point on AB. Okay, let me join. So I have joined P on P to Q, which is a point on AB. Now I have got this angle. So as I said, I have to make this angle once again. Visualization is very, very important. Therefore, my dear, now this angle should be equal to this angle. Now, let me see. This is my compass. Now, with the help of the compass, I am going to draw an arc. So let me draw an arc. This is my arc. Draw little bigger. Okay. This is my arc. So I have drawn an arc. After you have drawn an arc, what you need to do? You need to draw the same arc from point P on this side. So let me draw the same arc onto the from P on the, such that the alternate angles are equal. Now let me measure the length of this arc. So this is the length of this arc. See, this is, I think that you people can see it properly, clearly. This is the length of the arc. So I have measured the length of the arc. Now the length of the arc from this particular point up till here is this. Similarly, the length of the arc from this particular point should be this. So naturally, the length of this arc is equal to length of this arc. Now, using your scale, what you need to do is to join this particular point and this particular point P. So in that case, my dear, you will find that your line will be exactly parallel to the previous line AB. I hope this is loud and clear. Okay, this was your question number 8, and this was your first part, which says that draw a line parallel to AB passing through P, isn't it? Now, the second part of the question is in number 2. What I find is that they have given you the same sum. It is the same sum. They have given it to you, isn't it? They have given you the same sum. Now, how it is different? How it is different? A little different. So, I'll be talking about how this sum is little different. What they have done is they have given you a line somewhat like this, isn't it? Actually, they are fooling you. Actually, as I said, they are fooling you. So, this is my line AB. This is my line AB, okay? And they have given you point P over here. P somewhat over here. P over here. And they have asked you to draw a parallel line passing through point P. So once again, you people can see that this is my parallel line which will pass through P and which will pass through P only when the alternate angles will be equal. So these are the alternate angles. So what I am going to do is, why not to slightly tilt my sheet in such a way so that the same question, this question is equal or it is somewhat same in comparison to the first one. Therefore, let me join P to this point over here. So let me join it. So I am going to join P, okay, P to a point over here. So I have joined it. Very good. Now, after I have joined, what I am going to do? Once again, let's see what am I supposed to do. I am supposed to make the alternate angles equal. Means this angle should be equal to this particular angle. So let me mark this arc. Let me take a proper arc. So let me take a proper arc. So this is my proper arc. I have taken the arc and I have to take the same arc from point P onto this side. Okay, so I have taken the same arc. Now, I have to make the alternate angles equal, means the length of this particular arc should be equal to length of this arc. Now, let me measure this arc, the length of this arc. So, this is my measurement. I have measured the length of this arc. Okay, so this is the length of the arc. Now, from here onwards, I am going to mark the same length. After you have marked the same length, what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to join this particular P and the point over here. This particular P and the point over here and extend it. So when you will extend, what you will find that the line will be parallel. The line will be parallel to AB. And why it is so? The reason for that is the alternate angles are equal, isn't it? Now, let me tilt my sheet like this. Okay, this means I have done my part. I have played my part, isn't it? Now, what you'll find that in the next number or in the next sum, I find that the same question has been given. The same question has been given, but again there is a big problem. Why? Because they have given you. They have given you a line AB. This is your line AB. They have given you a line AB. Okay, let me draw this line. Okay, AB. So they have given you in the third part. Okay, in the third part. I hope this is loud and clear. Okay, AB. This is my line, and they have given you a point over here, P. Now the children get confused that how to draw a line parallel to AB passing through P. So I said it should be somewhat like this. This is my parallel line to AB. Okay, and this can be parallel only when the alternate angles will be equal. Okay, so when the alternate angles will be equal, why not to tilt slowly my sheet or your notebook in such a way that my sum becomes similar to the first one. See? So what am I supposed to do? I am supposed to join P on a point over here. So let me join P to a point over here. Okay, let me remove this parallel line, because I will get one parallel line which I had been asked. Okay, so this is a point Q over here. Very good, well done. Now I have to make this angle. Once again, my dear, have a look and try to visualize it. This particular angle should be equal to this particular angle, because they are alternate angles. Okay, we can take also this angle, but it will be quite big. So these two angles. Now let us measure the arc. Let us find the arc length, isn't it? That what is the arc length? So this is my arc that I have drawn. Now the same arc I have to draw from point P onto the other side. So I have drawn the same arc over here. Now I have to make the arc length of this particular arc. Let me extend it. Yes, this is my arc length. Now the same arc length I have to take it from here. I'll mark it, and then whatever point of intersection that I'll get between these two arcs, I am going to join that with point P, isn't it? So when I will join it with point P, you will be surprised to find that the line is actually parallel to the previous line. Now you can tilt your sheet and bring it to its original position, and you will really find that you have played your part, isn't it? Okay, now few questions will be given based on this. Please try to solve it. Okay, keep studying. This is my request. Okay, why? Because time and tide waits for none. Thank you.